Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. God, whose mercy is without measure, through the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Mercy, grant that we may know your loving kindness on earth and come at last to the glory of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, now there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life is Christ Jesus, has freed you from the law of sin and death. For what the law, weakened by the flesh, was powerless to do, this God has done, by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for the sake of sin he condemned sin in the flesh, so that the righteous decree of the law might be fulfilled in us, who live not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For those who live according to the flesh are concerned with the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit with the things of the Spirit. The concern of the flesh is death, but the concern of the Spirit is life and peace. For the concern of the flesh is hostility toward God. It does not submit to the law of God, nor can it, and those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it, for he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Alleluia!
Alleluia! Alleluia! Alleluia!
Jesus, about the Galileans, whose blood Pilate had mingled with the blood of their sacrifices. He said to them in reply, Do you think that because these Galileans suffered in this way, they were greater sinners than all other Galileans? By no means. But I tell you, if you do not repent, you will all perish as they did. Or those 18 people who were killed when the Tower of Siloam fell on them, do you think that they were more guilty than everyone else who had lived in Jerusalem? By no means. But I tell you, if you do not repent, you will all perish as they did. And he told them this parable. There once was a person who had a fig tree planted in his orchard, and when he came in search of fruit on it, but found none, he said to the gardener, For 3 years now I have come in search of fruit on this fig tree, but I found none, so cut it down. Why should I exhaust the soil? He said to him in reply, Sir, leave it for this year also, and I shall cultivate the ground around it and fertilize it. It may bear fruit in the future. If not, you can cut it down. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So the call to conversion, the call for change, the call for renewal. And so the effort is that of cultivation and fertilization, as you can see in the example of the parable. So this cultivation and fertilization must be a direct understanding and a willing to do it, a willing to change, a willing for conversion, a willing to turn back to God and to live uprightly by keeping his commandments of love of God and love of neighbor, of prayer, praise, of thanksgiving and petition, of contrition, of supplication, of taking care of those who come by your path and seek your help, my help. A conversion is a radical transformation on all levels of living, all levels of living. And that means that a complete submission to God's will in my life, and of course my love for my neighbor as I love myself. How do we do this? By God's grace. It's not by our own good work, but it's our work cooperating with God's grace. That's important to know, isn't it? To cooperate with God's grace, to dive into the mystery of what we're called to be. And that's an everyday occurrence. It's an everyday occurrence for all of us. And so the fertilization or the cultivation, what do we do? The first thing is to make a good examination of conscience. We're called to do that every night, aren't we, before we go to bed? To examine our conscience and to see how we really did during this day. All the graces that God gave us during the day, to see if we took advantage of it. And ask for his mercy for those times that we have not taken advantage of his grace. Make a good confession. Confession is very important for the soul. It's an encounter with Christ, in which Christ comes as the divine physician. He comes in his mercy to cleanse our soul. It's a second baptism, isn't it, confession? It's always seen as a washing or a cleansing, a renewal back to him. So this is part of the whole understanding of conversion, of this change. And then for the graces that we need to continue on the journey. Perhaps a whole new understanding of how we're to act and behave that everything now is in light of the gospel. We're looking through the lens of the gospel. So whatever we did before that caused us to sin, we want to avoid that and now begin doing it differently in this perspective of Christ and the gospel. We have to make a conscious decision about that, isn't it? Faith is a conscious decision by God's grace to move into that direction, not to rely on our own strength and ability and not to say, I can't do that. We could do all things in Christ who strengthens us. St. Paul reminds us that in the letter to the Philippians, I can do all things in Christ who strengthens me. That's right. There's a determination and there's a willing to do it. And then we rely on God's grace to allow that to come to fruition. So that's the cultivation and the fertilization, so to speak. And here, should I cut down this fig tree? Because this fig tree is not doing anything. It's just there. It's not producing any fruit. Let's cut it down. No. Let's just wait. Let's just wait and let me work at it. Let me cultivate it and fertilize it. Oh, that's with me and you. No, we don't want to be cut down and thrown into the fiery furnace. Our life is so precious in God's sight. So God gives us time, and that's what we have, right? We have time, and time is quick. It passes by very quickly. So we want to take advantage of it, and we want to dive into its mystery and its meaning. That's what it's all about. Today is Saturday of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and we usually opt to take one of the collection of masses of the Blessed Virgin Mary on a Saturday, especially since our parish is named after the Blessed Virgin Mary. And today we look at one of those masses that's called Mother of Mercy. And how beautiful that title is, Mother of Mercy, because she possesses mercy because God has been merciful to her. Even in the Gospel of St. Luke in the Magnificat, she utters that prayer of mercy, that he has bestowed mercy upon his people, and how beautiful he has bestowed that mercy upon me, and allow me to, of course, be the mother of the Savior, the mother of the Redeemer. It's all by his grace, because his grace is mercy. His grace is flooding my soul. And how beautiful we go to her as the mother of mercy and petition her and asking her to pray with us that we may receive God's mercy, a mercy that calls us to conversion and a way of life, to discipleship with him, to be one with him. As we continue our journey at Mass, and as we continue our journey and taking this Mass with us wherever we go, and the fruit of the Mass, may it really accomplish in us the work that God wants to do with us, and to allow God to do his work. It's already accomplished. It already is ready and set and prepared. Everything is done. We have to now invite him in and welcome him to continue that within us. In other words, I say this all the time,
distant lands, may they be blessed with the spirit of wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local leaders, may the Holy Spirit inspire them in actions to strengthen the community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For farmers and all those who work the land, may God bless their efforts as they bring in this year's harvest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this worship community, may God continue to help us grow in love for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially those who have no one else to pray for them, may they rest in eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Jackie Hardy, Peter and Suzanne Casada, Carol and Robbie Casanita, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Donna and Bosley, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the spiritual benefits of our annual 40 hours devotion, may all of us have a deeper love of God's font of mercy, His font of eternal life through the Eucharist, and may our love for the Eucharist grow stronger each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
of it, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and Paul, the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
All generations will call me blessed, for God has looked on his lowly handmaid.